Hey guys. Well, first of all, sorry for now. It's my other neighbor that's building something. Building something for his alpacas, I think. But anyway, recently I did a hand drill video try. That try was less than stellar. Basically, the material that I had to work with, I mean, you guys saw it. It was super small. It was super crooked. So when you are dealing with subpar materials, sometimes your technique has to change in order to overcome or try to overcome those materials, or your technique just plain sucks because you're dealing with that, you know, it makes your technique suck. So basically, and then I am very inexperienced at it. A friend of mine messaged me and told me something, so I want to try that. And I was able to harvest a piece of mullen just now. I just got back from fishing and I saw this when we were driving down the road. So the end piece, you know, the base here is about the size of my thumb, and down here where it gets skinnier, it's, you know, the size of my pinky finger or something. I think I might turn this upside down because I think it's going to be too much friction up at the top here. This little section, actually I might even just cut this section off because I think this would be a good bow drill set. But anyway, it's got a ton of cracks in it. So I've been told that the cracks don't really matter with a bow drill. I'm not sure about the hand drill. We'll give it a try. Anyway, I got to clean this up, polish it up so that my blisters don't immediately happen. They're going to happen, but just so that they don't immediately happen. And anyway, we'll get to processing this and maybe try a little better try. Maybe try two techniques. Try the natural way first, and then after that, the thumb technique, if my hands aren't completely destroyed. Okay guys, well, might as well give it a try here. I've already got some blisters, you know, from that last video, but they're kind of stiffened up a little bit. I know you guys, there's a couple of you guys said, why in the world are you over the top of this board like this? Well, I've actually tried this before, this method, and then recently Dave Canterbury posted a video on it. Guys, my shoulders are shot. Doing the work that I do, I've never really been able to work above my head real well with my hands. That's kind of what I have to do at work sometimes. And it just, I mean, my shoulders are shot. Literally I get, you know, if I go to bed at 9 and wake up at 4, that's 7 hours, I probably get 4 or 5 hours worth of sleep just because of my tossing and turning. I sleep on my side and, you know, pretty soon my shoulder and my arm goes numb and I flip over to the other side. Whatever. We all have physical limitations. Mine aren't that great, but still, you know, it is something. And I don't have the strength. I can't put it out in front of me and get the downward pressure necessary, even sitting down, to make it work. You know, maybe with better technique, maybe with just a little more practice I could, but for right now, this is how I'm gonna try it. I'm going to, and it's got some pretty serious splits down there, and hopefully that won't affect it, but anyway. Maybe back up just a little bit, but this way I can, you know, put a lot of upper body weight. Thank you.
Wow, that's the closest I've ever been. It actually smoked for a little bit. I think if it wouldn't have slipped and I was able to keep going, I think it would have worked. And Steve, you're totally right, man. I was extending my hands. Usually I'd be having blisters by now. I was extending my fingertips way too far. The problem that I'm having, that I've been having in the past and also now, is as soon as I start getting good friction, I don't have the gumption or the whatever to keep spinning it. So I mean, I know it's like perfect friction and perfect. I mean, you can totally tell because it's just like a bow drill or whatever. It feels the same, and I'm not able to push through that. I need to catch my breath just for a second. That's a forearm workout. I was real close, man. If that stupid thing wouldn't have slipped out, I might have had that. See that? So what it's doing is
it's pithy in the middle, so it leaves a little hump or whatever in the middle there. Oh, right there. So I don't know if that, you know, that's gonna cause friction probably where I do not want it. So I'm just gonna try to carefully grind this down. I don't know if you can see the blister starting to develop right there. And I'll tell you what too, guys, I cheated and I put a little bit of pine sap on my hands. So, oh, that wasn't too cool. The wind blew my dust away. Look at that. Wow. Huh. Starting over from scratch. That's not cool. So I'm almost at the point where I'm thinking I might have to do the cheating method because I can't afford to get
horrible blisters on my hands because I work with my hands. And, you know. Alrighty. I wonder if I needed this thing to be a little thicker. Maybe we'll flip it over. I think I'm gonna flip it over, cut it down a little bit, and then with it thicker like this, my hands won't rub together maybe quite so much. All right, I'm gonna do that. Okay, well you can see the little sucker starting to puff up a little bit. I've got maybe one more try left in me. Made a new socket. The wood's really crooked. On to the cheating method. I will say that using that fatter end definitely worked a lot better for me. I would have thought a guy could have got an ember that fast. I mean, what the heck? This is a tough row to hoe. And in case you're wondering why I'm going at it at an angle like this, my socket sucks. So that's why. See, I would have thought you could have got an ember by then. And maybe this, you know, I've only tried it with this aspen, maybe. Maybe I need a softer wood. Onto the cheating method. Okay, well all my dust stayed there, so that's good. And my knee pad here. I'm just gonna try to maybe get some, just heat up the board a little bit. That's disheartening. Okay. This is a very split piece. Maybe that won't work. Very split piece. And now, Terry, I'll give her a shot sitting down. Now that this is a little bit better spindle than last time, and I'm short again. It's getting short. Oh, come on. Doggone it. Jeez. I think I might have had that one too for... Darn. Okay, lesson learned, I think. Darn it. Almost gone. Really? Really, really? Okay. Unbelievable. The socket's smoking, not the smoke.
Getting bigger. You get your hands all wrapped up in these effing thumb holes. So there's my hands, and I've had enough for today.